Welcome back to Startup Street. Now, ahead of World Environment Day, which is on June 5th, we decided to catch up with a disruptive clean tech company, Bangalore-based Devik Earth, on their flagship air pollution control product, Pure Skies, on the impact that is created through their technology and on their future expansion plans. We have with us the CEO of the company, Dr. Srikanth Sola. Dr. Srikanth, welcome on the show. And you know, you are a cardiologist who decided to work on improving air quality after you saw air pollution killing many patients, including the youth. And you developed and tested your product over 10 years before launching Devik Earth in 2018. Can you begin by telling our viewers a little bit about your product, Pure Skies, and how it uses AI technology to reduce PM10 and PM2.5 particles and how much it cuts down on the levels of these particles?
Sure. Thanks, Mugdha, for having us on your show. What we do is we create air pollution control equipment that's plug and play. And the great thing about this technology is that it works over large areas. And that's very key if we're going to improve air quality for lakhs or even millions of lives. The way we do this is basically by speeding up what happens in nature. During the lockdown, all of us would have been at our homes, and if we go back to our cars or two-wheelers, we'll see a layer of dust. What happens, very briefly, is that in nature, these dust particles collide. They have positive or negative charges on them, just like a magnet. They collide and they settle out. What we do with our Pure Skies technology is we use pulsed radio waves, exactly pulsed Wi-Fi, and this actually increases the charges on these microscopic pollutant particles, causes them to accelerate faster and settle out. The end picture is that our customers typically see air pollution improve at their facilities by more than 50%. And we, because everyone is breathing cleaner air, we've actually seen sick leaves reduced by 11% year on year, productivity go up thanks to cleaner air.
Okay, that's encouraging. And you target heavy industries, office spaces, etc. Can you tell us what the growth has been like over the past couple of years? What is the kind of installations that you've seen for your product, both in India and globally?
Sure. We deal with two types of companies, those that create pollution as part of their work. So that would be cement, steel, thermal power, mines, and so forth. And then there's another large group where they don't create pollution, but they certainly wish to avoid its effects. So this could be hospitalities, corporate real estate, schools, and so forth. And what we've seen is that while the pandemic, of course, has closed down markets for certain areas like hospitality, increasing metal prices, increasing commodity prices have really shot up the output of steel, cement, and others, for example. And that has created a very intense interest in technologies like ours, which are able to provide clean air or at least improve air quality across large areas. Our largest installation is 750 acres, for example, at a steel plant. This allows us then to provide clean air at a fraction of the cost, perhaps, of what the traditional air pollution control equipments would provide.
Okay. So you're seeing a lot of demand for products like right. What you have made. And can you tell us what your revenue run rate looks like right now? You know, we understand that you've seen a big jump in your revenue targets over the past couple of years.
Yes, we've had to revise our revenue targets several times. We did about 2.6 CR worth of revenue in the first year and a half altogether. And our revenue target for this year was 12 CR, but we're already well on our way to passing that. I expect that we will actually do about four times that much by the end of this financial year. Interest is very strong, especially amongst the heavy industries, because there's really no other technology out there that competes across this kind of large area.
Okay. So you're expecting to change your revenue targets by 4x. It'll be 4x higher than what you initially
yes.
thought. And that is very encouraging, definitely, from the environmental perspective as well. Lastly, if you can quickly tell us, we understand that you are also in discussions with NASA for deploying your products for some of their missions. Could you quickly tell us what that is about and what the status is right now?
Sure. So because our solution works so well against microscopic polluted particles, what scientists call PM10 and 2.5, NASA has taken a keen interest in our technology. The problem they face, though, is very different from, say, pollution created by heavy industries. when their spacecraft lands on the moon, it kicks up a lot of lunar dust. There's not much gravity on the moon, so that dust tends to stay suspended for a long time and can interfere with the instruments that are on those spacecraft. They're looking for technologies that can bring that dust back down so that their instruments can start to work properly again. And we've been working with NASA, I think, for the last year and a half, working on how this might go through. It's really exciting because it changes how we apply the technology in a very lightweight, very rugged situation on the extreme temperatures that you might see on the surface of the moon.
Okay, that sounds interesting, and we will come back to you on as and when you sign that contract and as and when your product is deployed with NASA's mission. But Dr. Srikanth, thank you so much for joining us today. With that, it's over to you, Shruti.
Yes, Mugdha, it's Friday.